has been built, it is also the architect of humanity's future. As education ministers, you are the Sherpas leading mankind in our efforts for development, peace, and prosperity for all. In Indian scriptures, the role of education has been described as being key to bring joy. Vidya dadati vinayam. Vinayat yati patratam. Patratvat dhanamapropti. Dhanardham tatah sukham. It means true knowledge gives humility. From humility comes worthiness. From worthiness, one gets wealth. Wealth enables a person to do good deeds. And this is what brings joy. This is why in India, we have embarked on a holistic and comprehensive journey. We believe that foundational literacy forms a strong base for our youth. And we are also combining it with technology. For this, we have started the National Initiative for Proficiency in Reading with Understanding and Numeracy, or Nipun Bharat Initiative. I am glad that foundational literacy and numeracy has been identified as a priority by your group as well. We must resolve to work on it in a time-bound manner by 2030. Excellencies, our objective has to be to provide quality education with better governance. In this, we have to adapt and use new e-learning innovatively. In India, we have taken several initiatives of our own. One such program is the Study Waves of Active Learning for Young Aspiring Minds, or SWAYAM. This online platform hosts all courses from class 9 to the postgraduate level. It enables students to learn remotely and focuses on access, equity, and quality. With over 34 million enrollments and more than 9,000 courses, it has become a very effective learning tool. We also have the digital infrastructure for knowledge sharing, or Diksha portal. This is aimed at students in remote areas and those unable to attend regular classes. Teachers utilize it to deliver school education through distance learning. It supports learning in 29 Indian languages and 7 foreign languages. It has witnessed over 137 million course completions. India would be happy to share this experience and resources, particularly with those in the Global South. Excellencies, to make our youth future ready, We need to continuously skill, reskill, and upskill them. We need to align their competencies with evolving work profiles and practices. In India, we are undertaking skill mapping. Our education, skill, and labor ministries are working in tandem on this initiative. G20 countries can undertake skill mapping at the global level and find gaps that need to be plugged. Excellencies, digital technology serves as an equalizer and promotes inclusivity. It is a force multiplier in increasing access to education and adapting to future needs. Today, artificial intelligence offers great potential in the field of learning, skilling, and education. With opportunities, technology also poses challenges. We have to strike the right balance. The G20 can play an important role in this. Excellency, in India, we have laid emphasis on research and innovation as well. We have set up 10,000 Atal Tinkering Labs across the country. These are acting as research and innovation nurseries for our school children. More than 7.5 million students are working on more than 1.2 million innovative projects in these labs. G20 countries with their respective strengths can play a key role in promoting research and innovation, especially among the global South. I urge you all to create a path for increased research collaborations. Excellencies, your meeting holds immense significance for the future of our children and youth. I am glad that your group has identified green transition, digital transformation, and women's empowerment as accelerator for achieving sustainable development goals. Education is at the root of all these efforts. I am confident that this group will come out with an inclusive, action-oriented, and future-ready education agenda. This would benefit the whole world in the true spirit of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. One earth, one family, one future. I wish you all a productive and successful meeting. Thank you.